Dear Volodya, my name is Volodya. Here we know that in spring you are coming to the SSR for a concert in Moscow and Leningrad. Is that true? We'll be very happy to meet you, and only very sad that your sister is dead. I didn't see my family for 6 years. I don't know how they look, how they are. When I left Russia, my niece was 9 years old, now 70. Sure, they come to Moscow to meet me.
Here we go, goodbye. See you in Moscow. Now you have the boxes in already?
No.
Oh.
So you gotta come over to me, a little bit.
You see where you are, Joe?
Yeah, and I'm trying to line it up so that you can go in the slot.
Come over here, take a look where you are.
I can't see.
You're way over the way you are. All You're right. too far over where you are.
My board is right behind me.
Now we gotta lift it up a little.
The slot, you hear?
Now lift it up a little. One, two, three, lift. Now you got it now. All right, just hold it. You got it. All right, come on.
You gotta do this. Right, you hold it.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Come in.
Вашей дочери.
Дочка приедет к концерту специальной, внучка приедет.
Я.
И Петя есть. Ты же спрашивал
Кто?
Про Петю. Петя – это Жоржа сын.
Я, он.
Ты спрашивал
Сколько
про
меня.
Ему 50. Да, 50.
Он свистит.
Ванда замечательно выглядит.
Лена.
О, Лена, nice to meet you.
Там есть...
The daughter of my sister.
Do you have perhaps a greeting for the Soviet people?
I will have, yes, definitely.
With the piano.
With the piano, too, especially. With the words, too, maybe. The ambassador of peace.
товарищи, разрешите телевидению пройти. Да вы что?
Да, слева. Слева два. 25-26. Ну, прекрасно.
And then I spent all the night here because I wanted to get the ticket by all means, but afraid to miss it. From my childhood, it was my dream to hear Vorovis in life. I have got many records, and now my dream will come true.
Thank you. Thank you.
I play piano because I saw my mother playing piano and I wanted to play like her. And then my uncle was coming from Kharkov, the pupil of his cabin. We call him Uncle Who Play Loud, you know, because he played loud. And I said, I want to play like him one day. When I was 6 and 7, you know. But when I was 10 and 11, I didn't want to play like anybody, only like myself. We play 4 hands. I have 2 piano. We play sometimes 8 hands, which they don't do now anymore. You know, they have music for 8 hands. At the moment that we play 9th Symphony of Beethoven and 1, 2, 3, 4 pianos, it means my father, my mother, me, and my sister. We 4 play. It took, you know, every 3 bar we stop. So, because my father was wonderful to count, a mathematician. Oh, my mother couldn't count 3 bars, and my sister played piano good, and I was dissimilar a little about that, something doing. So that was, we did it. And then they play cards, you know. They play kind of whist, a preference. That was like bridge today. And my father loved to play cards, and my mother liked poker. And I play poker sometimes, cards too. And you see, after dinner, here we go to sleep. But there after dinner, when it's finished, in 1 hour they put samovar, and then you have zakuski after dinner. So they put samovar, you take tea, and then you have paska, some cookies and something like that. And people come from all the, it's a big house, you know. Friend, there is a musician, there is a doctor, there is a lawyer, there is somebody, they come in and we talk. Then in the school, I was always 2-3 years behind because I was not going to the school. At 8 o'clock in the morning when I had to go to the school, I was going to the promenade and going to the friend to play the piano somewhere. So they were calling me the crazy pianist in the school when I was small already. So I started.
Already at the time.
But that was not around this age when you played for Scriabin?
Scriabin died in 15, you know. I played for him 1 year before he died. In 1914, I played for him. In 14, I was 10, 11 years old. 10, 11.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember that day when you played?
Yeah.
Tell me, what was it about?
I came to him. It was a 5 o'clock afternoon, and he had the concert the same night. Can you imagine, it's this Friday, somebody comes to me to play at 5 o'clock. That means afternoon, he played at night. At 3 o'clock, I would tear it out. But he wanted to be nice to my uncle. And my uncle told him, you have a nephew who is so talented, you have to hear him. So I came here, he was sitting like that. He was crazy, you know. And finally I played, it takes 10 minutes only.
Елена Александровна Скрябина.
Вы дочь Скрябинка?
Да.
Я знал вашего отца.
Знали, да.
Я играл ему. Мой дядя был его ученик.
In 25, they went to the Crimea. They traveled together. They went together to the Crimea.
Ну, когда они уйдут, то мы можем разговаривать.
Да.
Скрябин told my mother that, I told you that. That he will be a pianist and very well, but you have to educate him. He should know the literature, the painting, the everything outside of it, the whole music, to opera, orchestra, everything. And so my mother did that and my father did it. That means he was my advisor in a way.
Thank you.
after I played for Scriabin, he came for a concert. And through Scriabin and things, we asked, my mother asked Scriabin if it is possible that my son play for Rachmaninoff, maybe he will teach him later. So he arranged that when he played anywhere, I can go to hotel and can play him in Europejskie Gostinice, I remember which hotel. And then we make one after his concert, Rachmaninoff's concert. Next day, we make an interview.
An appointment
for 3 o'clock to come there. We came there, I was, oh my God, I was nervous, Dada was nervous. Because, you know, Scriabin is Scriabin, but Rachmaninoff, that's a piano, he could, they don't play piano anymore. That would be for my whole life. So we asked the portier, what is his room? They said that he left 1 hour ago. Later in New York, he said, I want to get rid of that appointment. So I thought, I didn't want to see anybody. That was very unpleasant. But later we were friends. Nobody knew Rachmaninoff better than me, of here now alive people.
So you think he'd be glad? Hmm? He'd be glad.
He will be happy now to see me here, yeah. That's what I say, I miss him to see me here. To see the country where I'm born, that's one of the most important reasons. So that I cannot wait anymore. And maybe next year I will not play anymore. I don't know. I maybe, you know. So that was the reason. And I want to see my family too. And wanted to make peace between every country, not to kill each other.
Thank you.